It is a season to be joyful, and we welcome you all here to Langford Chapel. We welcome you if you've been before, and we welcome you if it's the first time too. And it's good to sing the praise of God together. We're going to start with, well, it's my favourite carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, Glory to the Newborn King, Peace on Earth and Mercy Mild, God and Sinners Reconciled.
Gospel of John, chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. And down to verse 14. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Let's pray together. Our Father, we thank you for this joyful occasion, and we thank you for the good news We've already heard some of that. We thank you that you sent your Son into this world to be our Saviour. Father, we thank you that tonight we are not celebrating a legend or a fairy story. We are celebrating something that actually happened. And we are amazed at this. We can't understand it. We realize it is a miracle for God to come here, to be born as a baby, to become a real man. But Father, we thank you that we believe it is true. And as we sing your praise tonight, we ask that your blessing might come upon us. We ask, Lord, that if there are those who perhaps struggle to have faith, that they might receive help from yourself, and that we might all rejoice together as we sing of that which God has done. So come and draw near to us, we pray, for we want to glorify the Lord Jesus tonight and to give thanks to you, our God and Father. Amen.
Amen.
Just a couple of announcements. There will be refreshments after this service, and you're very welcome to join us. It's all being laid out there. I promise that when I disappeared for 5 minutes just now, I didn't take anything. It's still there. I resisted the temptation, so there's still plenty for you. And just to say also that you will be very welcome here on Christmas morning at 10:30. Please note that our Sunday time of 11 o'clock, but 10:30 on Christmas morning for a short service here. And next week we will have our usual services at 11 and 6:30. So you're very welcome here, and we will now take up a freewill offering. You're not obliged to give, it's entirely voluntary, and that will be given to the charity Caring for Life, based in Leeds, which helps vulnerable animals. And we've been interested in that for many years in this church, and regularly supported in practical ways and in prayer. So we invite you to take that opportunity, if you feel you would like to do that, to support this work. And I do have a short video in the back room there that you might like to see after the service. Thank you.
The Bible reading is from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25, reading from the NIV. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
Thank you. The next carol, just on the inside page of your sheet, while shepherds watch their flocks by night.
Reading is taken from Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, starting at verse 1, reading through to verse 7. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, every one to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you. And our next carol is, O Come, All Ye Faithful, Joyful and Triumphant. Now, I don't know that they do it down here, but as I pointed out the other day, where I come from in the Midlands, the ladies sing the first, O Come, Let Us Adore Him, in the chorus, and then the men sing the second one, and all together on the third one. Am I out of order? Am I the one that's out of line? Or does anyone know that? Yes? Right? I was getting some nods, so let's try that then. O Come, All Ye Faithful. Thank you.
Oh, beg to differ, George. Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 8 to 14. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men."
Come now, long expected Jesus, born to set thy people free. From our fears and sins release us. Let us find our rest in thee.
I think I would like to hold the most beautiful jewels. Can you see all the and the most luxury, the gold, the rubies. Oh, that's what I want to be when I'm cut down. So his desire was to be a treasure box. Okay, right, we'll put him there. Now, tree number two, growing in the lovely wood, he thought, right, what would I like to be when I to be nice and a big tall tree. I know I would like to be a great big ship. And if I was a great big ship with the most beautiful sails, I could sail all the oceans, I could carry kings and princes, I could be ever so important. Well, that was his aspiration, was to be the most fantastic ship, probably better than, or I could only know the names of some of the important ships. The Titanic, we don't want to be the Titanic, do we? But a really important, important ship. So that was his aspiration. Okay, so we have a treasure box, we have a ship. The third tree, he thought, you know, I quite like it here. Do you know, I'm really happy just to stay in this forest. And, do you know, I think I would just like, when people look at me, that I could point the way to God, to the heavens. I don't want to be cut down. So he was happy to stay where he was. Until one day, along came a little man with his lumber jacket and all his gear with him, and he had his axe in his hand, and he thought, there looks to be a nice tree. I think that one will do well for me. So he got his axe off, and to tree number one, he got his axe, and tree number one fell. He thought, that's wonderful, I'm going to be a treasure box. But do you know something? The carpenter got the wood, and he did fashion it into a box. But it wasn't quite the box that tree number one, what sort of a box is that? What to feed animals in? Well, that really wasn't what I intended to be. But there we go, that's what tree number one ended up. As a feeding trough for animals, well, his aspirations were a bit dashed, do you think? Yeah, I think so. Maybe. Well, tree number two, along came Guy again with his axe. Thought, there's another nice tree. Do you know what I think? That would look well in my shipyard. So he got his axe, whack, 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 and he got his tree. He was so happy. This is going to make the most fantastic boat. So here we go. Let's see if I can get it without breaking it. There we go. Well, it's not quite the ship that he had thought he was going to be made into, is it? Absolutely not. A little rowing boat. Well, that's not a great big ship. Oh, well, he'll just have to be happy with that for now. Well, tree number three. Here he was. He wanted to stay there. Well, along came the lumberjack or whatever, and tree number he was left just as a pile of wood. Look at that. Well, their aspirations were a bit dashed, weren't they? They'd have been really disappointed. Well, time passed, and one beautiful starry evening, a lady gave birth to a baby. And the lady led her baby in the feeding trough. Tree number one held the greatest treasure the world has ever seen. Some time passed, and there was 13 men out for a walk one evening, and they got into this boat. And as soon as they got into the boat, the storm rose up, and the waves began to create a very unpleasant feeling for them. The sleeping man at the front of the boat got up and said, "Peace, be still." And the storm was calm. Tree number two knew that he wasn't carrying kings and princes, but he was carrying the King of Kings in his boat. The greatest ship. Nobody was carrying the greatest king that ever lived. Well, tree number three, he was so disappeared, he was just a pile of wood. One Friday morning, a man walked up a hill with a very, very heavy cross on his back. The pile of wood, they formed into a cross. Tree number three wasn't very happy because he felt dirty. He felt that this poor man that was being nailed to his wood, that it really wasn't very fair. But he realised his aspiration had come true because everyone now looked to him to point the way to the Saviour. So the three trees had the greatest aspirations, but God used them in a very, very special way. And this Christmas, I just want to pass on to you the joy of knowing Jesus. The babe in Bethlehem, the man of Galilee, and the man who died on the cross for each one of us. Thank you.
Amen.
This reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 15 down to 20. So it was when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marvelled at the things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told them.
Well, how do I follow all that? That amazing story. I noticed that not only the children were listening, but the adults were listening too. And that was tremendous. Thank you very much for that. And of course, George is singing. We had the privilege a few days ago of hearing George singing over there in Yatton. And I immediately approached him and asked if he would come here. So thank you for singing for us tonight. And it's those last few verses that have just been read to us by Lewis a moment or two ago that I want to bring to your attention just for a few moments now. And it's Luke chapter 2 and verse 15. And the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." There's an awful lot in those few words. First of all, we see that there was some urgency for these shepherds. They had had a visitation from angels. They had been told that the promise, the long-given promise that we were singing about earlier, had come about, and that there in Bethlehem they would find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in a manger. And they believed it. And did you notice the important line of what George sang to us? Believe. Believe. That's the name of the song. And it makes a point for me, better than I can do. They believed what they had been told. And they said, "Let us now go to Bethlehem." It was a matter of some urgency. Indeed, in the Greek language, the tense that is used indicates that they were saying, "Let's do this immediately." In fact, verse 16 tells us, "And they came with haste." They were in a hurry to get there. They believed what they had heard, and they went. And then they said, "And see this thing that has come to pass." Now, of course, it had been prophesied for generations that one day the Messiah would come into this world. But they then, not having yet seen him, they believed. And they said, "We will go and we will see. Not we'll check it out, but we will go and we will see this thing that has come to pass." And thirdly, they said this, "Which the Lord has made known to us." They didn't think and say to themselves, "Well, maybe we imagined it. Maybe we've been sitting up watching these sheep for too many nights. Maybe we've sort of had a little bit too much wine or something like that." But they actually said, "We believe this. We're going to go to see this. And we realise that it is something that the Lord has made known to us. Now we have listened tonight to several readings from the scriptures, from the Bible, from the New Testament of the Bible. And our response to it can be this: well, it's just an old book. It's just a story. No one knows whether it's true or not. Or our response to it can be, this is God speaking. This is what the Lord has made known to us. And if we have that response, then we will want to enter into the joy that they had. Because straight away, immediately they went back to their sheep, from then on, they began to tell people around what they had heard and what they had seen. So these were shepherds, and they went back to a few scraggy sheep, and yet their lives were changed forever because they had seen that Christ child, the one whom Ricky told us just now was laid in a box from a tree that had been cut down. And they had seen that Christ child, and they had believed what God had said, that he had come into the world. And the challenge of Christmas for us all tonight is this: will we do what George was saying to us? Will we believe? Or will we miss the opportunity? Miss the joy of Christmas Day and of the truth that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's probably the most famous verse in the Bible, John 3 and verse 16. It remains with us the choice to believe or not to believe. The choice to say this is so important, we must immediately go. We accept what we have heard, what God has told us, and we must now go to Bethlehem and see the Christ child. And that's when we do that, that removes it from the idea of a legend or an old story. And then the truth that God sent his Son into this world becomes real, important to us, and can change our minds as it changed the lives of those shepherds so long ago. So God bless these thoughts to us. Let's sing our last carol, Silent Night, Holy Night, All is calm, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace. I don't know if you all know this, but it is the 200th anniversary of the first singing of this carol, Silent Night. Thank you.
Oh,
disappeared, it's not because they didn't like my sermon, at least I hope not. But I think they'd rather put the kettle on. So do please stay if you can afterwards and have some refreshments. Let us pray. Father, thank you. Thank you for being with us tonight. Thank you for those things that we've heard. We pray that we might respond as those shepherds did before, that we might believe. And we might want to share in the joy, in the love that you have shown in sending your Son to be the Saviour of the world. Help us, Lord, if we've never done so before, help us to believe and then to live for you. And like those shepherds, to tell others of the love of God shown in our Lord Jesus Christ. Shown in his coming and shown in his cross. We give you thanks in his name. Amen. Amen.